Now, you've had a lot to say about plastic bags. Helen Lansdell emailed to say, get rid of plastics and all non-fully recyclable plastics. We must do it now. Sean McCauley tweeted, logic is lost. Bag alternatives would not be used enough to justify their additional environmental harm. Proposal reduces stores' costs whilst increasing consumers' cost. Lynn Renouf also emailed saying, ban plastic. Bought load of building timber wrapped in 5 layers of heavy plastic wrap. What's that about? What is that about indeed? All right, panel, let's open it up again. Georgina Beyer, really nice to hear her on this debate around transgender issues because, yeah, I'll be put my hand up, I did there. It is a confusing issue and I'm learning more about it as I go. But I think she made an interesting point about the public being brought along, didn't she?
Mm. I thought that was a great comment, actually, and sort of giving us permission to be confused and saying, you know, rather than wallowing in your victimhood, bring the public with you. And I know from my own experience, my daughter's best friend is transgender and I've known her since she was 6. Clearly, this was a kid who was born in the wrong body. And I look at her now and she's now this beautiful girl, age 18. She's not defined by that. She's actually a fantastic filmmaker and an actress and doing these amazing things. So she's not defining herself simply as that. So I think that was a really positive thing to say, that yes, it's confusing, but also this isn't
That's
about...
That's all right.
Yeah, it's, you go ahead and be what you want to be
Kaapua,
in life.
Yeah. What do you think?
Well, first of all, I want to say I think diversity in our communities is a beautiful thing, and I think transgender people are a huge part of bringing that to, you know, to what makes us unique as a community. But you don't know what you don't know. So it's really important that as a public, we are told, you know, this is not what you do, this is how you do it, this is what it means to me when you make me feel like that. We've got to be open to these discussions. That whole point around the toilets made me laugh, because that's so true. We get so hung up on the toilets, and if someone said to us, actually, that's not the biggest thing you could do for me, what you could do is this, then that would be awesome.
Yeah, but the thing is, like, when Q+A raised this issue a couple of weeks ago,
yes,
the Council for Women called it dangerous. Said we were dangerous for raising it. Is that...
For me, the main thing is, and I go back to something Tariana Turia told me, nothing about me without me. The main thing is you listen to the voice of the people it affects most. So you listen to the transgender community. And saying that, there's probably no one view on it. And this is, you know, that point, you have a right to be confused. They have a right to be diverse in what they think. And as a community, we're all learning, you know, and we have to respond to that diversity through what we do. And it's different strokes for
What do you think,
folks.
Ashley? I mean, you're someone in the business community.
Yeah, yeah. Ashley.
No, but I mean, seriously,
Ashley?
It has been an issue for businesses trying to get their head around it.
One of the good things I took from that was the acceptance that there is a broad diversity of views. And I mean, I quite openly sit on the very much on the conservative side of this particular issue and have done for most of my life. And that's unlikely.
So what does that mean, though?
Well, it means that I think in the context of that conversation, it means that there are a range of views and that those views are all legitimate, and that society needs to recognise that rather than beating up on people who don't buy into a particular viewpoint, accepting that different people for different reasons, perhaps for faith positions, come at this from different perspectives, and that we need to recognise that as society evolves into whatever direction it's going to evolve, that we need to bring all of those viewpoints along.
So it means accepting if some people aren't accepting of transgender
people? I
think
so, yes I do. I think that there needs to be a recognition that not everybody's going to necessarily hold the same viewpoint, and that those people are just as entitled to that viewpoint. And that may change over time. I mean, there are things that have happened. You know, slavery was accepted 100 years ago. Society's accepted that was perfectly legitimate. Nobody holds that as a view now. So it may well be that some of these views naturally change and evolve over a period of time.
I think they're already evolving. And I think it's really important that as a community, we play a role in supporting that evolving. Because I want to live in a diverse society where it's okay to be whatever you want to be.
I think people may have
a different perspective on being transgender. Within the confines of their home, what they do is their business, as long as they don't harm someone else. And that's the problem. The problem is sometimes their views are harmful to others.
Yeah. Well, when we get people turned away at a gym.
Yeah.
Yeah. Absolutely. Yeah. I couldn't agree with that more.
Ashley, you are on the coalition, on the Free Speech Coalition. I wonder.
I love the way Josie keeps laughing.
Well, I just want to bring that up. I want to bring that up because aren't some of the views of Lauren Southern and Stephen Molyneux the types of views that are really pushing back in an extreme way at some of this stuff, and they're pretty unpleasant.
They are, and I think the.
So why are you going into bat for them?
Well, so firstly, not going to bat for them. Their views are repugnant, and I think most decent and reasonable people who view what those people have got to say would hold that same view, that those views are unacceptable. And wouldn't be held by the vast majority of Kiwis. I think the reason that particular position was important and why I was prepared to put my name to it when I was approached by Jordan Williams was because the bigger issue is the ability of a government to close down speech and say certain speech shouldn't be permitted because we don't like it. And as an extrapolation of that, the ability of a council to say we're going to close a facility off to certain types of views if we don't agree with them. That's unacceptable. Okay. That is unacceptable.
I agree with that. I think that it's easy to defend the free speech of someone you agree with. Yeah. And these people hold abhorrent views. But the best way to fight a person with an objectionable view is a person with a good view, with a good argument.
Yep.
You know, you fight bad arguments with good arguments.
I'll get a couple of comments from you on this.
Yeah, I actually don't agree.
Whoa.
I don't agree. I actually think they're very close to hate speech. I think as a community and a society, where that kind of talk is not acceptable, we should stand up and make a strong stand. There is one thing to have freedom of speech. It is another thing to use that particular right to impinge on the rights of others. And that's where I draw the line.
If you are harming people, yes. If you're standing in a theatre
and
saying
I find what they have to say very harmful. Harmful to Muslims, harmful to Islam.
You're offended.
But also, when somebody jumps in the water to prevent people from being saved...
But all you do is you... that's different.
That's harmful. And so their behaviour is harmful.
If you're saving a life, or if you're physically endangering people, if you're calling for people to go out and...
But I also don't think we have to provide a platform. You can have freedom of speech in your bedroom. You can have freedom of speech in a park.
I'm concerned about...
No, you've got to fight. But you don't have to provide a platform for them to express these abhorrent views.
I'm concerned about the proliferation of this term hate speech because it's dropping into the lexicon as an acceptable term. It is not...
It's actually in legislation. It's in legislation. There are provisions in legislation which define what hate speech is.
The provisions in legislation relate to incitement to violence.
It's clear we're going to have to come back to this issue. It is not going away. We delved into it last week. We will delve into it again weeks coming. Some very quick hits and misses because we're running short of time for all of you.
Okay. Well, my miss is the Minister of Immigration, Ian Leese-Galloway, backing off a commitment to increase the refugee numbers. And I think, you know, you've got to stop equating refugees and migrants with housing. If you don't want to be accused of sounding like Trump, then don't sound like him.
So
made a commitment to do it. Do it. It's a moral obligation. These are people running away from terrible crime, terrible atrocities. And my hit is the Commerce Commission taking Wilson's car parking company to suing them for uncompetitive behaviour, and the whole of New Zealand is cheering like we won the World Cup. These guys honestly clamp their offices, fine them and make them prove on a piece of paper that they don't deserve to be fined first.
Very good. Terrible. Some hits and misses?
The hit for me is Tudor Flavel getting a new role. As CEO at Te Wānanga o Aotearoa. He has now transitioned off the executive team for the Māori Party, but we are so happy for him, and we are happy for him to continue his kaupapa Māori. I don't actually have a miss. I was going to use Lauren Southern and Stephen Molyneux coming to New Zealand as my miss, but we've already gone there, so I'll pass on.
Actually, you've got about 30 seconds for some hit and a miss.
The miss is the government missing the opportunity to condemn Hamas for firing over 200 missiles into Israel when they've been quite happy to have attacked Israel and passed multiple resolutions against them over the last couple of years, starting with the National Party in 2014. So there was an opportunity to show some moral leadership here and they failed to show it. The hit very much around the UK's decision to put New Zealand along with Australia and US at the front of the queue for the negotiation of an FTA. That's great news, shows that these guys are as focused on free trade as the previous government.
Thank you very much, panel.